The Ngatshana Conservancy and Community Forest cover some 10,120 square kilometers of communal land in the northeastern of Namibia, making it the largest in the country. Most of Ngatshana's 6,000 residents are indigenous people belonging to the Khoisan or Junghasisan community, sometimes referred to as Bushmen. The establishment of the conservancy represents a break with a history of marginalization and land dispossession of these people, many of whom survive on less than $1 a day. Local communities have taken ownership of the management of natural resources and the development of socially and environmentally responsible tourism under the conservancy framework. Land and resources planning exercise carried out in all of Ngatshana's 24 villages result in virtually all of the conservancy members endorsing the management and utilization plan, which now guides resources management. The community decided to recover previous level of game population and biodiversity to the area, which were reduced during the conflicts between South African armed forces and apartheid liberation fighters, are being realized through the implementation of a 5-year game reintroduction and water provision program negotiated with a private sector partner. Also, the conservancy has taken up reforestation effort and the protection of areas deemed by local people to be of importance in terms of biodiversity and traditional practices. These areas now place to host to populations of rare and endangered round antelopes and wild dog, among others animals and plant species of importance to local people. Current effort to establish a community forest within the conservancy will allow the membership to gain additional rights over the management of forest product and to protect and sustainably manage the substantial forest stands, which are important in terms of biodiversity and serve as a carbon sink. Food security remains the primary goal for much of the conservancy membership. Many of the conservancy members continue to rely on bush food and field product for their daily subsistence. Efforts are now underway to improve food security for the local population through a number of innovative measures established by the conservancy. The management and utilization plan of the conservancy and the resources monitoring effort of community rangers have served to protect food and other products found in the bush, which are consumed by the local people. The conservancy has also established a revolving scheme which will bring chicken farming to the villages and community vegetable garden, which will provide additional source of nutrition for the membership. The membership also benefits from a meat distribution program derived from a closely monitored and regulated trophy hunting program based on a contract between the conservancy and a private sector partner. Despite recent advances, the social, economic and cultural livelihood of the San and the biodiversity on which these are based have come under increased threat as a result of resettlement effort on the part of individual and group interested in exploiting the resources of the conservancy for personal, political and economical gain. The conservancy membership has benefited from effort of the conservancy and its partners to secure and protect land rights, resource rights and human rights as a basis for future development, driven and guided by local needs and aspirations. Substantial additional income now flows to the membership through the conservancy regulated threat of devil's claw and tourism operation in a responsible partnership with government and private sectors. In recent years, Ngatshana has been the single largest producer of organically certified devil's claw, a plant product traditionally used by the San to cure a number of ailments and which now finds its way into anti-inflammatory medication available around the world. Unique local graft production has also received marketing and sales assistance from the conservancy. A project has been established to provide local artisans with environmental friendly local produced ostrich eggshells that provide the primary material for artistic expression and economic benefit. At the same time, tourism development have brought a sense of pride as well as monetary income to the San members, while providing a stage for the sharing of San traditions and understanding with the rest of the world. It is on the basis of this strong beginning that people of Ngatshana wish to move towards the future, one in which their land and resources rights are secured and biodiversity is protected as a responsible global citizen residing in Namibia.